We are going to learn basic rules in order to understand the DC machines concept. So now get into topic. So first rule is the Maxwell-Kirk's rule. So this shows that this is a screw. So the direction of the rotation is gives the magnetic field direction, and the direction of the current towards to the downside. Okay, this is the screw rule, Maxwell screw rule, where so in this, so it is a spiral metal rod, a hand. To find the magnetic field using the screw rule, when we turn a corkscrew clockwise from right to left, it goes to inside of the crux. So if magnetic field is, the magnetic field is in the clockwise direction, the current is inside. Okay, if the magnetic field is in anti-clockwise direction, the screw is outside, means the current is upward direction. So next we are going to discuss about the Maxwell right hand rule. Okay, suppose we hold an electric wire with our right hand, shown as like this. So assume the current direction of the thumb, if the current directed like this thumb direction. Okay, so from bottom to top, so the direction of the field will be in the direction in which the our fingers curl. Okay, the fingers curl around the conductor as like this. So the magnetic field is created in the direction as like in the figure. Okay, if the current direction is downwards, okay, so the field direction is anti-clockwise direction. Sorry, it is clockwise direction, it is the anti-clockwise direction. Okay, so this slide shows the Maxwell's Kirk's rule. So hold the corkscrew in your right hand and rotate in the clockwise direction in such a way that it advances in the direction of the current. Then the direction in which the right hand rotate will be direction of the magnetic field lines of force. So next rule is, so the diagram shows the Fleming's left hand rule. Okay, it shows the happen when an electric current enter into a magnetic field, you need to content your hand into a unilateral position. So for this rule illustrate shows as like this. Okay, so here the shown figure, if the index finger, this is the index finger, index will point the direction of the, this is the index finger. So this shows the magnetic field direction. Okay, this shows the magnetic field direction, whereas the thumb, this is the thumb. So this shows the direction of the force. Okay, this shows the direction of the force. Coming to the so this is the middle finger. So middle finger shows the direction of the current. So basically the left hand rule used in the direction of the rotation of the motor. Okay, so it depends upon the direction of the current. So So this gives the a complete illustration between the left hand rule and right hand rule. Okay, so here it is. It is shows that a left hand rule, it shows it used in the motor itself. Okay, it is gives the generator rule. So in order to find the current direction in the generator, so the thumb is shows the motion of the coil, and the index finger, it shows the field direction, and the middle finger shows the direction of the current generated in the generator. Okay, so this gives an idea about the left hand rule. So it is already explained before. So the direction of the force acting on the current carrying conductor, with the help of the Fleming left hand rule, we can determine the direction of the force acting on current carrying conductor placed in a magnetic field. Okay, so this is already explained. The middle finger represents the current direction. The forefinger shows that the direction of the magnetic field, and the thumb shows that the direction of the forcing acting along the conductor. So basically this is used in motor. Whereas a Fleming right hand rule, so it is in order to determine the direction of induced EMF in the conductor. So if you place the right angle fingers, thumb and forefinger and middle finger with each other 90 degrees apart them, so we will assume as like this, the thumb shows represents the direction of the motion of the conductor, whereas the forefinger, this forefinger shows the magnetic field direction, and the middle finger shows the direction of the induced EMF. Basically this is used in a generator to determine the direction of the induced EMF. So Lenz rule, so basically Lenz rule tells that about that the direction of induced EMF in by the generator itself. So according to this law, the induced EMF will be acting in such a way that it opposes the very cause of the production. Means here itself, whenever current carrying placed in a magnetic field, it experience or it generate a induced EMF in it. So here it is, according to Lenz law, the cause opposes the effect. Okay, so this is the induced EMF equation in the generator, E is equal to minus N into the rate of change of flux.